Okay, so 87 times 3. Okay, 7 times 3 is 21. Carry the 2. 24. 261.
What? No, that's not right. It's 258.
No, I did the steps. I checked it. I did it right. It's 261.
No, you're wrong. Oh, come on, let me do it. See, I get 258 again. Everybody knows girls are bad at math.
It's a commonly accepted premise that girls are worse at math than boys. This kind of claim is very appealing to many for a variety of reasons, such as explaining why there are so few women in science, technology, engineering, and math careers compared to men. Demonstrating the claim is often approached pseudoscientifically. Pseudoscience is a process of approaching a claim in what appears superficially to be scientific, but is fundamentally flawed. Here, the question being asked assumes that the claim is true, based on logical fallacies, such as it being common knowledge, the argumentum ad populum, and that the claim is correct, which is begging the question. The scientific approach looks at the claim and asks, is it even true? Scientific approaches rely on the falsifiability of the process, where pseudoscience assumes a truth and doesn't want to falsify it.
Hey Jenny, are you and Dave going to the dance on Saturday night? No, he's playing in the game earlier, so he said he'd be too tired. All those boys care about is sports. Why ask us out if they never want to do anything with us?
Hey Dave, you going to practice tonight?
Yeah, winning the game on Saturday means we'll go to state.
What about Jenny? Won't she complain you're not spending enough time with her? Again?
So I want to go shopping to get new shoes for the dance. But we have to stay around Friday afternoon for the career showcase. I'm going to go look at the education table, nursing, and librarian careers on Friday. What about you, Mary? I'm going to check out the pre-med, the engineering, and whatever other science ones that there are. Are you sure? That's a lot of math and science. Hey, so is nursing.
What tables are you guys hitting at the career showcase? Mrs. Black says we have to go to at least 3 to get credit.
I'm going to the police table, the army. I don't know about the 3rd yet.
My mom insists I go to the pre-med and the pre-law ones, but I want to go to the army one too.
I'm going to the engineering and physics tables, and probably computer science. Nerd. Jock!
The trope of girls being more interested in fashion and social events, and boys just wanting to relax and watch or play a sport, is so common, it's the basis of many episodes of sitcoms. A pseudoscientific approach to this claim is to accept that these are the only two choices, and that girls do one, and boys do the other. Scientists would start with seeing what activities are available, and if there is a difference in participation by gender.
I want to go to med school, and so I know I need general bio, genetics, microbiology, organic chemistry, and physics, but what else should I take?
Well, yes, but that's a lot of science courses. Do you think you can handle all of that?
Yes, I know I can. I did really well on my SATs.
You should probably also take calculus, but that's pretty advanced math.
I should be able to do calculus.
We get a lot of students who come in as pre-meds. Most of them end up changing their major. Why don't you think about what else you want to do now, so you don't have to play catch-up again later on?
It's well known that there are more female nurses than male ones, and more male physicists than female ones. STEM, or science, technology, engineering, and math, has long been considered the domain of men, to the point that doing an image search of famous scientists on the internet brings back many images of men, and only a few of women. A pseudoscientific approach to this claim is to assume that there is some inherent difference between girls and boys that causes these choices, which is the argument from nature. Additionally, there is the idea that traditional career choices are best. The scientific approach starts with the claim itself to see if it holds up.
In a lot of ways, we've been told we can be whatever we want to be. But when you look at the success of women in science, technology, engineering, and math, you have to wonder. Even though girls now get one-third of the top 1% of the SAT math scores, up from less than one-tenth 40 years ago, that isn't reflected in the college degrees achieved. Although women received 58% of the bachelor's degrees in biology, we only got 19% of engineering degrees and 18% of computer science degrees, with the proportion of women taking the courses in those disciplines dropping rapidly in the first 2 years of college. I did well in high school, and I scored well on my SATs. And when I went to college, I declared a pre-med major without hesitation. But I didn't get a lot of encouragement, and there weren't as many mentors as I could hope. So, is it because girls are just bad at math?